Fortnite Chapter 5 Season 3 ends next week. And oh my days, we've got a lot to look forward to. And well, I'm gonna be talking about it all in today's video because, we know a lot about Season 4 and damn, it's really gonna be dark. But before, I gotta talk about this season's mini event. Live event. Yeah, we're pretty much getting an actual live event this time. Because right now, in-game at Brutal Beachhead, you can see a timer. And this timer is literally the same timer we've had for previous live events. And also, it turns out that some specific tags in the files, which are normally used for big actual live events, are being used for this season's event, which is very interesting. But we don't know yet if this event is going to be having its own separate mode, a key art, an actual name, because that's normally some things that an actual live event would have. Plus, by the time I'm recording this, this event happens in 4 days and Epic hasn't posted anything about it. So I think this event is gonna be big, but I don't think it's gonna be bigger than the Big Bang or something, but it's definitely gonna be much bigger than the last two mini events. So yeah, this is very interesting, and right now it is being classified as a proper live event, so I'm very excited. And also, we might even see a countdown in the lobby soon, but I'm not sure about that. Now, the pipeline, which was the general build up towards this event, is now finished. And soon, Nitro will start slowly fueling into the Leviathan ship. And once it's fully fueled up, the Leviathan will move. But, you see, that's where things get a little bit interesting. It seems that the Leviathan will move a bit, and then, the rig is gonna get destroyed. Well, we don't know if it's gonna get fully destroyed, but it's gonna get damaged. And this is because the Pandora's box is underneath it. Yes, ever since the Pandora's box disappeared, it has been in the wasteland under the rig. And the machinist had been using it to create Nitro. And I'm not gonna lie, that's actually pretty interesting, but I'm kinda surprised we didn't think of that theory before though. But damn, all this Nitro, all of Megalodon's power had been coming from the Pandora's box. And now it kind of makes sense that Megalodon got so pressed when Hope stole his Pandora's box gems.
My Pandora gems! And it is irritating! Those are mine! They cannot have them!
But yeah, in the event, Pandora's box is gonna rise from underneath the rig, causing it to just blow up, and it turns out the whole entire pipeline is gonna explode as well. And this is obviously gonna disrupt Megalodon's plan by a lot. Also, the second the timer reaches zero, this sound is gonna play. In which that sounds like a freaking bomb siren. Also, I forgot to mention, this season's event is codenamed Rude Egg, which is very interesting because Epic do like to codename their events after foods. For example, durian being used for Big Bang, fritter being used for the device, and radish being used for fracture. And so it seems like that Fortnite are still keeping with the tradition, and again said, this season's codename is Rude Egg. But yeah, there's also another sound effect that will play in the event as well, and this might be when the Leviathan starts moving, I think. So yeah, that's a pretty long one, but it does sound very ominous and very cool. So, Phil Bouncer has been cooking. Now also, the aftermath of this event was kind of leaked as well, and the top of the wasteland isn't looking very good. Parts of the exploded pipeline are everywhere, there seems to be a few craters. The rig seems to be looking okay-ish, well, in the leaked loading screen, it was literally on fire. So I don't think it's gonna get destroyed fully, maybe just a bit though, we're not entirely sure. But underneath the rig, there will be the Pandora's box, and it made a crater, and there seems to be lava. Actually, no, this is nitro in the crater. Not gonna lie, from this image, it really does look like lava, but nah, it's just Pandora's box energy. But damn, though, the Pandora's box is gonna be causing a lot of damage. But, like, why is the Pandora's box even being involved in this event? And who exactly is rising it to cause all of this? Well, the answer to that, my friend, is the Wanderer. Yep, he now has full power of the Pandora's box and its energy, and that's what he's been gaining all this time. And in fact, he's gonna be using it against us next season, because like I predicted, it's confirmed that next season we will be facing him in a war. But I'll get into that in a sec. Now, from all the leaks about this season's live event, it's pretty obvious that Megalodon's plan is gonna fail. Which is kind of funny, but not at the same time, because like, he was acting so threatening. For example, oh, I'm gonna rend the island in two. Yeah, you know what I mean. Like, we actually thought he was gonna be that big, tough, scary villain who actually wins, but no. But I'm not gonna lie, Megalodon has actually been a really good villain, a very well-scripted villain as well. For example, he had some very good voice lines, in which he actually had a lot of voice lines as well. And also, the betrayal goes crazy, because we knew that the Wanderer and Megalodon were working together in some way, thanks to Hope's vision. But like, on the day of Megalodon's big plan, the Wanderer just messes up everything by rising the Pandora's box and causing multiple explosions, which completely screws up the entire of Megalodon's plan. But to be fair, I'm not surprised, because we all thought that the Wanderer would be a very arrogant and selfish character. And well, now it's been fully confirmed that he is, using all of the Pandora's box power against us and completely screwing up Megalodon's plan, which is some great teamwork there and makes him even more of a betrayer than Sloane, but at least Sloane made up for it. So just nice one, Wanderer. We really are getting a glimpse of your peak villainy here. But now, moving on to the more protagonist side of everything, Hope is now contacting us via radio transmissions. So far, we have heard two messages from her.
Hope here. If you see the Wanderer, do not engage. I don't know what's coming, but it's not pretty. That said, I promise you, no matter what comes next, we will fight it. We're never doomed until we surrender.
So this is the first ever time of Hope speaking to us via radio transmission. And she tells us to just kind of ignore the Wanderer. And she also reveals that things are gonna get dark soon. But Hope is being independent, she is having hope. And she's confident, and she's like, we will not be scared of this Wanderer, we will not surrender. Unless we are doomed, which is a word that quite a lot of people are saying on the Fortnite Island right now. Because at a somewhat degree we are doomed, but not at a level where we would have to surrender. But either way, let's roll the next message.
I'm the big shark man!
Don't worry, friends. We're back to your regularly scheduled programming. Bit of a warning, though. Things might get pretty bad on the island soon. Why is it every time you knock over a villain, two more always pop up right behind him?
So Hope starts off with having a bit of a laugh and mimicking Megalodon. But then she warns us that things are soon gonna be getting bad on the island, in which they are. And then she questions why every time she defeats a villain, two more pop out after. In which Hope's actually got kind of a point there. But it won't be the same with Megalodon, because he's gonna get proper screwed over by the guy he was working with. And also, going back to the live event, this season's event is gonna be a tad bit similar to the Chapter 5 Season 1 event. This is obviously because the Pandora's box is gonna arise again, and we're gonna be experiencing some of the same natural effects, for example, the rumbles and the earthquakes, which does make a lot of sense, and again, I am very excited for this. Now, after the live event, we're gonna be getting the sixth and final stage of this season's storyline quests, which is pretty much just all about the Pandora's box and the Wanderer, hence the name, Beware the Wanderer. But yeah, and well, these voice lines for the quests have been leaked, and well, it does spill out some very interesting information. So let's go over the voice lines together.
Confession time. I've been talking to Magneto.
Oh, great. Because he seems trustworthy. Why are you talking to Magneto?
Well, he came to talk to me.
So Magneto, the secret skin for this season, is pretty relevant for this season's storyline. And he's been talking to Hope because he senses danger. And he knows that the Wanderer is on the horizon. Especially as the Wanderer now has very strong powers of the Pandora's Box. But I'll get more into Magneto in a sec, because he is actually extremely important into how we will get into season 4.
Things are about to get weird, aren't they?
Well, I summoned a magic water ghost, so... Ghost? I am a seer. A soothsayer. A very powerful lady!
So as left from last time, the Oracle is now back in the quest. And she was actually unintentionally summoned by Hope. And this is obviously because Hope found all of the Pandora's gems and put them all in the gem holder, which eventually summoned the Oracle. But yeah, Hope isn't actually fully aware of who the Oracle actually is, referring her as a ghost. And then the Oracle says that she is a soothsayer and a very powerful lady, in which she is. She can literally see fate. But yeah.
Don't get it twisted, Miss Underground. Do you want to talk or not?
Yeah, fine.
Okay. Walk with me. This box should destroy you, but instead, it talks to you.
Now, we somewhat knew before that the box is very mystical to Hope and talks to her, but the Oracle just confirmed it.
What does it show you? What does it say?
When I connect to the box, it promises me everything I've ever wanted. Peace, harmony, hope. I know that it's just showing me what I want to see. That if I give in, it'll destroy me.
So now Hope knows that the box is baiting her by promising her harmony, hope, and peace. But this is just bait, because Hope knows that if she even touches the state of the Pandora's box right now, which is obviously in very bad condition because the Wanderer now has 100% power of it, she will genuinely get destroyed. So the Wanderer led Hope into all of this, and Jones did actually warn her in the beginning, to be honest.
Hope. I have direct experience with this sort of thing. When I got lost in the Zero Point, I got all the way lost, so just leave it alone. Power like that can't be controlled. Best case, it destroys you. Best case.
But Hope now knows that she is powerless, and if she even touches the box, then she'll get destroyed.
Hey, I know you. You're not gonna let that happen.
It's not that easy, Captain Tough Guy. Hope and this box, they're linked by fate. By the cycles of time and destiny eternal. But the Wanderer, his interference has warped this fate. His presence has rewritten the stars themselves. And now it is not enough to simply close the box.
So now the Oracle got into her fate reading and revealed that the Pandora's box and Hope are always linked. But with the Wanderer now being here, the stars have been rewritten and the fate has been warped. In which this heavily damages the strong relationship between Hope and Pandora's box. Meaning both of their fates are not looking good at all right now.
You must fight. And you must win. Do you see it now? You were meant to be the hope at the bottom of Pandora's box.
Okay, now the Greek mythology reference is very interesting here, because we were always speculating what was actually at the bottom of this box and what hope could be given to us, but we were never told. But you see, the character Hope is our hope. Sounds a bit stupid, but it's true. Her relationship with the Pandora's box is that great and strong that Hope is our only hope to surviving the Wanderer and defeating him in an all-out war next season. But I'll get more into that in just a bit, okay?
I get it. It's literal. It's literally your name. Take it up with the fates, okay? This Wanderer has taken the box's power for himself, and he has sealed your fate along with his.
So, yep, the Oracle just confirmed everything I just said about the fate. But when the Wanderer gets defeated, something's gonna have to happen to Hope as well. Which brings us into my theory that Hope will die for us, but I'll get more into that in another video.
There is no turning back for you now. You must fight this Wanderer.
I'm just Hope. I don't know if I am who you think I am.
If you take a stand, others will follow. You need not stand alone. But Hope, you already have everything you need. Prepare for a war, my child, a war.
Yeah, sorry for it cutting off. I know things were getting very deep and profound there, but the Oracle is right. The theory of us going into a war against the Wanderer next season is fully correct. And while even though Hope may think it, she is not alone. Because she has Magneto, and while you're probably like, bro, what's Magneto gonna do? Well, you'd be surprised, because if we really want to win against the Wanderer, we need Magneto, as he has the ability to send Marvel superheroes to the island. And well, this is what makes him so important. He is gonna send Marvel superheroes through the Rift Beacons to the island. And they are all gonna be standing with Hope in an all-out war against a Doctor Doom. Wait, Doctor Doom? I mean, the Wanderer. Oh wait, I forgot, they're most likely the same person now. Yep, I'm not joking. Ever since the latest update dropped, the chances of Doctor Doom actually being the Wanderer have risen extremely. This is because many characters around the island says we are doomed. And even though we are doomed, they mean it like doomed. It's like a little hint that Doctor Doom is actually the Wanderer. Well, at least we think that's what it's for. Because the word doomed has been suspiciously used a lot lately. And also, Magneto does say, I can't verify this Wanderer is who I think he is, but if it's him, if he's the one seizing that box's power, this place may be doomed. And well, unfortunately, it's most likely that Magneto is referring to Doom. Now, some of you are probably happy that Doctor Doom is actually the Wanderer, and if so, fair enough, I guess. But I mean, all that build-up and hype and speculation just for him to be Doctor Doom, well, it's just a bit of a disappointment, I can't lie. But also, guys, you know it's not 100% confirmed that Doctor Doom is the Wanderer. It's just very most likely. But whoever the Wanderer actually is, next season, they are gonna invade the island with their powers of the Pandora's Box. And we are gonna have to stand against him, with Marvel superheroes helping us to defeat the Wanderer, with the Oracle and Jones assisting us as well, and of course, the main fighter here, one of the bravest characters in Fortnite history. Hope. And she's gonna be getting some bluey powers, baby. So we really will be in a war against the Wanderer next season, who is probably the main villain of Chapter 5 at this point. And then that will somehow bring us into Chapter 2 OG. But again, guys, Fortnite Chapter 5 Season 4 starts in under 2 weeks. And well, we're gonna be getting an actual live event happening before then. And it's happening on Saturday, where we will experience the fall of the Wasteland Warriors. And of course, the main antagonist of this season, Megalodon. But yeah, guys, I was not expecting this video to be that long. But still, I hope you all enjoyed it, and well, a like and subscribe would always be appreciated. Also, join the Discord server, link in description. But yeah, guys, we are genuinely doomed. And on Saturday, we will be experiencing the beginning of the end.